Welcome to another edition of Fashion Counsel. Today I have the pleasure of being joined by Laurent Chedru, who is the Deputy General Counsel of Lacoste. Thanks for joining me, Laurent.
Thanks for having me, Tony.
So Laurent, you are responsible for worldwide brands of Lacoste, Gant, and Eagle, correct?
Right.
So what's your favorite territory to be responsible for?
I would say favorite is, of course, France, because okay. It's the origin of the brand, of the Lacoste
right.
brand. But I must say that I have always a pleasure to work with the US, because it's very different and very specific.
Yeah, and I'm sure if you were being interviewed by Greek Council, it would be Greece, right?
No, I'm sure not, Tony. I mean what I'm saying.
Yeah, good. Tell me a little bit about the DNA of Lacoste and how maybe it's changed or stayed the same from its origins.
Well, I would say Lacoste is quite old brand, because mm-hmm. Its origin is in 1933. So it originated, of course, with the famous tennis player René Lacoste. And he invented the polo. And he had this croc, which is
right.
world famous. And now, about the DNA, I would say that the brand has been, for a long time, mostly oriented through sport, through tennis. And what has changed in the last 20, 15 years is that we try to focus on how was René Lacoste at this period. It was the Frenchness,
right.
the elegance.
Agreed.
And so we try to mix this, keep this sport orientation, which is really our origins, and move it to sport and elegance.
And I noticed that you've been doing a lot more in the area of golf as well. This has become a big area for you.
Exactly. Golf has always been a very important area for us. First thing is, once again, because of history, because René Lacoste was married to Simone Thion de la Chaume, who was a very famous golf player. And she won a number of tournaments as well in the 20s. So the couple has always loved
sports,
tennis yeah. as well as golf. And now we try to orientate a little bit more on tennis for men and golf for women, I would say.
Interesting. So maybe you can tell us about the history of the crocodile. This is a pretty famous story, but I'm not sure all our audience knows it.
Well, the story is that in 1923, René Lacoste came in the US, I think it was in Boston, for the US Open, and the day before the final, he was shopping around in the city, and he found in a shop a suitcase which was made in crocodile,
oh.
Which was right. more common at this time. And his coach told him that if he won the tournament, he would buy this suitcase for him. So he won the tournament. I don't know if he did get the suitcase. And also the other explanation is that René Lacoste was never giving up. He was always playing and playing, trying to, even if he was in a bad position in a game, he was trying to get over it. So he has been called the alligator, because he was never leaving
his ball.
Exactly.
So beside the US and France, which you've said are two of your favorite markets, mm-hmm. where's Lacoste seeing its biggest growth?
Well, Lacoste is a worldwide brand, so we are present quite everywhere. Mm-hmm. I would say that our important growths now are more in Asia, Japan, Korea, China, of course, and also in Central America.
Of the territories that you're responsible for, tell me some of the differences that you find from a legal standpoint when dealing with Lacoste issues in the US as opposed to Europe.
Well, there are many issues that are quite different to deal with. Of course, France is known as a complicated country on the legal side, because we have a lot of protection, we have a lot of constraints, and we always say that the US is much more liberal and that you can do business as you like. It's not so much the case.
Right.
Of course, you can choose very, very easy to leave a partner or and to go to another. But you also have a lot of constraint on employees,
right.
Also a lot of constraints on consumers. And you have, of course, always this risk of huge trouble with the class action, which is something that is very specific to the US that we don't get in the same way in Europe.
You're lucky you don't get it in the same way, yeah.
Exactly.
Well, maybe you can give me an example of what you're talking about as to the differences you see in France.
Well, a clear example is the fact that in France, for some years now, you have this new regulation saying that to protect the other party, your partner, you even if a contract says that you have a 3 months notice termination, if you have been with this partner for 20 years, then you might need either 12 months or 18 months of notice of termination before being able to finish the relationship. When in the US, as I understand, if it's said that it's 3 or 6 months, then you can just rely on it.
Yeah, in the US, it's exactly right. We have more of a freedom to contract unless you're a dominant market position, but nobody in fashion really has that. Maybe you can tell me about some of the differences you find when you're dealing with the legal work tied to Gant compared to Lacoste.
Well, there's not much differences on the ground of legal issues, of course, as we have the same issues in the fashion business. I would say that difference is mostly on the capacity of negotiation you have, for example, with a lessor in a mall. When you are Lacoste, of course, it's much easier.
Yeah.
Not always easy, of course, but
right.
But much easier than for Aigle and for Gant.
Since I've been working with Lacoste in that period of time, you've brought in a number of designers that you've collaborated with. I remember a project with Ernest Sohn for jeans, and I remember Catherine Melandrino. This seems to be something that Lacoste likes to do, bringing either larger or smaller designers to do projects with.
Right. We like to work with a lot of designers, either very famous designers like Jonathan Adler.
I remember.
Also a young designer. We like to have them work on our Croc and finding new designs,
yeah.
and also new vision. And they grow up with us, which is very good for everybody.
Agreed. You've also done other collaborations. I know Roland Garros is something I always associate with Lacoste.
Yeah, actually, Roland Garros is one of our partners since 1970. It's a very old partnership, and we love being there, and it's really linked to the Lacoste brand, as
Absolutely.
René Lacoste was, as you know, one of the musketeers, and is everywhere in the arena, so it's really
part of you.
Exactly, it's part of Lacoste history. So we have this collaboration with Roland Garros, with the French Open, and we recently made a co-branding with them. So we have a number of polos and apparels that are co-branded with the Roland Garros Lacoste logo. It's very nice.
When I think of Roland Garros, I always think of Lacoste and the connection.
You're right. It's definitely a very important connection.
You've also done a co-branding with Club Med, right?
That's right. We have worked for a year now with Club Med to bring a new collaboration, a new co-branding, and to be able to sell to clients within the villages new polos with new design linked to the Club Med. As the Club Med has made a wonderful premiumization, and Lacoste is doing the same.
What are some of the legal issues that you have to deal with any sponsorship that you find yourself addressing?
Well, the issues we mostly have is about how we handle the contracts with any accident that might happen in the player's life. It can be either in his professional sporting life, he can be injured, he can stop for a while, but also in his everyday life, the behavior has to be linked always to
the high quality of the brand.
The high quality of the brand, exactly.
We're in a very interesting time right now. Retail's in flux, and a lot of people have written that they think retail, in the traditional sense, is dead. Is that your view?
I would say, of course, more and more people shop on the e-com, but I think it's different consumers, and we still have a lot of consumer in our shop, at least in Lacoste shops. And I would say when I see the results of Louis Vuitton or Hermes, we still have a double digit growth. I think there it's brick and mortar is not dead, it's not yet dead.
Right, it's complementary to I guess brick and mortar customers in the e-com.
Yes.
I know your parent company has recently done some acquisitions or joint ventures. Maybe you could speak to those.
That's right. We had quite an exciting period recently because we bought this Technifibre brand, which is a French brand, but is also present in the US, in Miami. And they are doing strings and tennis racket and tennis balls also. It's very complementary to Lacoste.
Right.
And the other important issue is that we bought, we are making a partnership with Pentland, which is our footwear licensee. So we are doing either a joint venture and taking the distribution. So we'll try to enhance a lot the footwear, the Lacoste footwear in the future.
Yeah, it's a very exciting time to be with Lacoste right now.
You're definitely right. It's an incredible time.
So, well, I really want to thank you for taking the time to meet with us.
It was a pleasure for me, Tony. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us for another edition of Fashion Counsel.